Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. In this episode, let me show you how to help out somebody by taking control of their Mac, starting with the Messages app. So maybe you've been in this situation before. You want to help somebody out. Maybe a parent, maybe a child, somebody that's not at your location and they're having trouble with their Mac, or maybe they're just trying to figure out how to do something and you know how to do it. It's difficult sometimes to tell them over the phone or using email how to help them. But you can take control of their screen using screen sharing. Now, a lot of times this involves configuring exactly where they are, what their IP address is, setting things up on their Mac and all that. But the simplest way to do it is to start by using the Messages app. If you're using iMessage to communicate with them with the Messages app on your Mac and their Mac, you can very easily take over their screen and show them how to do something or do it for them. So I'm going to start off by just going into the Messages app. So if you don't have the Messages app yet configured for you or for the person that you're trying to help, then you want to just go into Messages and you can go into Preferences, add your account to it, and of course have them do the same thing. And you can use your email address, usually your Apple ID address right there, as the way to contact them. So now that I've got mine set up and they have theirs set up and I have it here on my laptop next to my desktop, I'm going to contact them using the Apple ID of the other machine. And again, this is on my desk. I have two machines on my desk, but this could be somebody halfway around the world. And I'm going to type a message now at the bottom, just something to get going. And then you can see here on the other screen I've got a message and I can respond. Great. So now that I've done that, of course you can use this for normal chatting, but if you want to help the person out on a technical issue, you can click on the Details button here and then click on the Screen Sharing button, and you can either invite them to share your screen or you can ask them to share their screen. So we'll ask to share their screen. And you can see on the other machine here, we have a notification that then we have to accept. And once we do, we go into screen sharing. So now we've got that, and they're going to hear our voice over their speaker. So you're doing suddenly you're going into FaceTime and you are actually communicating with voice, just audio only. This is their screen and I'm seeing it inside of a window here, and you can see when I go in I can hone in on a specific spot and they will see there which spot I'm looking at. Now if I want to control what they've got, you can see I have here set to the binoculars for observe mode. I can switch to control mode and they'll get a question there whether or not they want to do it. And now you can see I'm actually controlling their cursor. So I can do things like, for instance, I can run an app or just anything I want down here. I'm basically controlling their cursor and their keyboard. So I can run Safari and it'll run Safari on their machine, and I can type. So if I was going to do something like, say, show them how to configure something on their Mac, I could do that by going to System Preferences and actually doing it. So I can now use all the standard screen sharing things here. I can even use a shared clipboard. I could set scaling so I can actually see their screen at full size and then move my cursor around to adjust where I'm looking. And when I'm done with this, I can actually just quit screen sharing or close the window here. And now we return here. Where we just are back in the regular messages chat, and I've helped them out. So this is great for helping out a relative, a parent, a child, anybody that needs help with their Mac from your Mac. It really works best when you're both using the latest operating system. If they're using too old of an OS, or you are, then it's not going to work out. So you want to make sure everybody's up to date to begin with, and then you can provide technical assistance to those that you want just by using messages, not having to set up anything special with your router or using any special software. You can just do this using the Messages app between two Macs. Now this whole thing could be thwarted by some advanced security protections, firewalls. Certain routers may not allow traffic over this port that screen sharing needs. But it should work for most people. You may want to try it out before you actually need it. So if there's somebody that you sometimes help out with Mac stuff, you may want to just chat with them on Messages, try taking over their Mac so they can see what it's like and you can see what it's like. And then when you need it in the future, it'll be very easy for you both to be able to set it up and do it.